Chu, welcome to part two of this very noisy secret recipe. This program has been brought to you by Secret Recipe. So let's see here. We are next to a major roadway going into like LDP. That's why it's a bit very noisy. So let's get on cracking. The food has arrived already. Let's go on cracking. So let's see here. This is the food. Yum yum. So cordon bleu, and we have the whatchamacallit. Corn. Okay. Set this up nicely so you can see it properly. Okay, oh fuck, this is embarrassing. Okie dokie, hopefully it works. No. Let's take a looky. Okay, so when it comes to the chips, I prefer to have it with a sauce. I say this Heinz tomato ketchup. I prefer ketchup compared to chili when it comes to Western food. Take some time to come out, fortunately. And of course, for a bit of variety, it's always ebony and ivory. Some chilies. Oh, fuck. So let's go on cracking. They don't have spoon, weird, but never mind. So let's taste the corn. Sweet corn. It's very sweet and nice. Love it. How about the chips? Chips is so. It's okay. Not as crunchy as what I want it to be. As I said in my previous videos, I really hate motorcycles which are very loud. I hate them a lot. Especially those very expensive ones. Those motherfuckers. I hate them. So this is 16 ringgit 80 cents, and this is the cordon bleu chicken. It comes with cheese inside. And let's go on cracking and see whether it's good or not. Any cheese on this one? Maybe the cheese is around here. Is this a bit of cheese? Fucking shit. Yep. Stupid bikes. Stupid super bikes. Noisy as fuck. Asshole. So it's quieter now since the burger is gone. So let's taste this chicken here. Shit man, this needs more salt. Okay. The chicken is a bit it's coming out already, the whatever cheese it is. I think it's okay. It's okay. Not that astounding. Chicken seems to be I don't know how to actually say it. Let me go and process my brain and see whether it tastes nice or not.
holding it wrongly. Yeah. Good. I think it's okay. The chicken, I mean, golden blue chicken is not something that you will write to your mother about. So I haven't tasted this type of chickens before. Maybe it's a different type of thing which I haven't experienced before. But so far, I think not that special. So far, but I might change my opinion after some minutes. Is oozing out already the cheese. You can see it's yeah, still a bit not as overcooked as it shouldn't, thank God. I know what it is missing. It is missing salt. I'm gonna get some salt. Get some salt. Because I prefer to have some salt, because the cheese is not salty, okay, not that salty, so put some salt onto it, it should taste nicer. But I'm loving this sweet corn. The cheese is oozing out, oh my god. So I haven't tasted this cordon bleu chicken steak before. So you can see the fine strands of the chicken. Tastes very very nice with salt. Now I know what it was missing. It was missing the salt. So it tastes better with salt. I put the cheese in the middle. You can see the layers here. I wish that they put bacon instead, but this is a halal place, so it will tastes nice with bacon, especially when my first complaint about this cordon bleu is the saltiness, which is lacking. If they put the bacon in it, definitely it'll be saltier. But this one does not have, so you only have to make do with the salt here. So it tastes miles better with the salt. Miles, miles better. This one reminds me of my friend who is now in Australia by the name of Jan Nettoklakika. Met him in Tauranga. Yeah, Tauranga. He loves to do chicken wrapped over cheese. So I always love to taste his chicken. Okay, I love to taste anything that's free back in New Zealand, because I was starving in New Zealand. Kinda. Love this corn. So very sweet. So this is going to be a very full meal because this protein here is one big lump of chicken, and also the cheese is also protein based. It's going to be lasting for a few hours. There's some caramelized cheese here. It's going to taste excellent, of course. Yep, it tastes excellent. Love the corn. Or have I said it 1,000 times already? So for this month itself, I'm going to be a very very busy boy. Very very busy. I have so many things to do. I have to go to, I think tomorrow Sunday, I have to go to Mar Trade for that motor show, because they have bikes there, so I'm interested in seeing the trades, the motorcycle trades, that is. Then on Tuesday next week, there'll be the Gundam Fair. It's starting on Tuesday, but I think maybe if I have the time or if I'm bothered, I would like to go on Monday and see how they are doing it with the preparation of putting the Gundams together, because that is always very interesting to see. Then there's the long-awaited trip to Batu Caves to see what it is all about. It's always I always see Batu Caves in the TV when it's Deepavali, so the Indians go there to worship whatever. Maybe worship Shiva, is it? I'm not sure. So I've been wanting to go there for some time now. It's only about 30 kilometers away from where I'm staying. So roughly it'll take me about, I think, 1 hour to get there. If I know the place well, if I know the roads well, then it'll take 30 minutes at full light speed through KL traffic. But I think I'll give it 1 hour plus, because I don't know the roads. So I'll be going at it slowly. Look at the corn. Then I think I'll be going to Ikano for quite some time, okay? A few times, maybe 2 or 3 times, God willing. I love ketchup. It's going to be a murder to actually clean all these utensils because it has the cheese on it. So next week also, I have to, like, on a Saturday, I have to go and visit my friend Jimmy W, because he will be, or we will be eating steamboat. So there will be another review on steamboat. Hopefully, I mean, I think the price will be expensive, fucking hell. Last time I ate, the second time in that monkey restaurant, monkey or whatever you call it, the fish head steamboat with soy sauce this time. Not with the, not the first one, I'm not sure what I ate, what kind of fish head it was, with the excellent sotong, with duck salted egg. Went this second time with Jimmy W and Isa Bell as well. Didn't film it because I didn't know Isa Bell that well, because well, paise, embarrass, as if I know the meaning of embarrassment. So that meal in Mang Thi, the second one, we were going Dutch, cost me about 30 ringgit, 30 ringgit. That's around roughly about 10 US dollars or 1000 yen or 6 pounds. Kind of like that really took a bite out of my expenditure. Took a bite out of my money, that is. $30 already can buy a non-grade pirated Gundam. Oh. Now I'm doing the hands of the Sasabe high grade TD Hongli. Still loving it. So what else do I have to do? There's a marathon somewhere I have to go and cover as well. A lot of things to do. And I think I'm going to like stay in KL for another month before I go back to Ipoh, and from there journey on to Penang for my Penang Hunt version 2.0. I'm supposed to go back early to test my blood in the hospital, but I don't think I want to go back that early. Oh, so I'm full already. I'm very, very full. Okay. I don't know whether I can finish this or not. Can tap out. This chicken here, I have to tap out. Fuck. Cannot eat it. It's too heavy. I have to tap out. I cannot eat anymore. Why not? Why not? I've seen my body through the video of the video that introduces how I actually take my videos, and I've seen myself in the reflection of the mirror. I'm not happy with the spare tires around my waist. Or I do like lose weight already. I've been playing basketball all the time, 10 minutes a day. Hopefully that will do the job, but I've been drinking quite a lot of Coca-Cola and coffee as well. Coffee is like the fuel for my well-being. So I think I'm going to finish my meal already. So it's a great time. I'll give this Cordon Bleu. Actually, I wanted to give it like 4 stars out of 10. 4 stars out of 10. But once I put the salt, I'll bump it up to 6 stars out of 10. So the salt saved this chicken. This is a personal preference, okay? I prefer it salty. When it comes to like say all these steaks and whatnot, the salt is very important. Even though they give you this one, but it's always the first impression that is the most important. Okay? Excuse me. But it's good meal. Good meal. Very, very filling. If you want to try really good steaks or really good Western food, go to Mount Erskine Hainan Western. Okay? That's near Batu Ferringi. You just Google Mount Erskine, M-T or M-O-U-N-T-A-I-N. Erskine is spelled E-R-K-S-I-N-E. E for idiot spelled wrongly, R for Roger, K for cunt spelled wrongly. Mount Erskine. E-R-K-S-I-N-E.
S-K-I-N-E, is it?
I'm not sure about that, fuck. But never mind, just go and type in Hainan Western in Penang. And put there Mount Erskine. Just Google it, or you can go into my old videos. I think I have that one. It is in my Penang Hunt series. Penang Hunt, okay? Penang Hunt, Mount Erskine. I did a video about them. The food there is very, very good. The sauce is very nice. Of course, it's non-halal, so too bad for you if you're a Muslim or a Jew. But the food is amazing. They have bacon, they have pork chop, they have chicken chop, they have fish and chips. It's really good, and the price itself is only 8 ringgit, okay? Fucking hell, 8 ringgit. You compare it to, like, say, what you get in KL, fucking hell, here is too expensive. But there in Penang, you think that it's very expensive. I mean, the food, that is. Not really true, okay? Penang has a very high cost of living, yes. Especially because of the land. They have limited land there, like Singapore is very expensive. You want to buy it? I mean, this is the forces of demand and supply. It seems expensive, but that is because of the land itself. So you can get great food, Western food, in Penang itself. 8 ringgit for a chicken chop, that is very expensive. That is like half the price of this one. And still tastes very good. So do go to Erskine, and I'm gonna go and see whether they can type out this or not. Okay, I'm getting less power already. So stay tuned for my third part, which is not about food, but about Gundam related stuff.